Hello. Yeah, I look a little different. Just got my hair dealt with earlier today. It's not quite what I would have wanted, but I'm not great about giving directions with my hair, so in the end, we just had to go really short with it. Anyways, welcome to a return to form. And what I mean by that is, of course, current DVD stuff. Now, just the other day, we had Stranger Things announced returning to DVD. That's awesome. Fucking amazing. Super happy about that. Even though I don't really play a lot of DVD anymore. So you're probably wondering why I'm covering this. It's because I'm hoping to make a return soon. I think I need a little bit more time, but I think within like the next month or two, at best start of the next year, I will be returning to DVD. And DVD content will start back up again. And I'm also going to kind of use this opportunity to say that expect a stream later today. Hopefully it's on YouTube as well. I should have that set up by now. And if you're wondering why there's been no videos, it's because I've actually run into a really major issue with DaVinci that I can't solve. So I'm going to have to fall back on one of my other suggestions. But I was trying to spend some time working on solving that, seeing if there was actually anything I could do. Because it's literally just like, well, fuck you, you're, I think it was my graphics card or something. It's got an issue, it's literally part of my PC, and it's like, we don't work with that. So anyways, what if we look here, I have seen and heard three theories so far, and I really want to address each one, and then myself, what I believe. So, for starters, the most prominent theory that you will hear, as well as what I would say is probably the most likely, is that this is possibly a tease for Chucky. Now, the reasoning why is because a lot of people have mentioned that there was a scene from the TV show that has a knife rack similar to this, like, looks really similar. And, well, it has knives on it, obviously, with one missing. As well as Chucky has been known to use kitchen knives. The little stool here that's like right here being, you know, something that Chucky could hop on top to grab the knife. You know, stuff like this is all very much implying the possibility of it being Chucky. Is this a bit of a stretch? Yes. Are Dead by Daylight teasers a bit of a stretch? Yes. I want to remind you guys real quick because I just want to say it now. One of our teasers for Pinhead was literally a picture of Father Campbell's chapel spinning like a wheel with a lot of knives on it, and the only thing changed was there was one singular pin in it. Yep, that was an intentional change to tease Pinhead coming into Dead by Daylight. They sometimes do these really obscure things, you know, they sometimes make references, stuff like that. However, there are two other theories that are going on, and I want to address both of them myself as well, and see if there's anything else I can really say to this that matters here. So, next is that a lot of people have said that this looks very similar to Michael Myers' knife. So, what if this is implications of a Myers rework? We have Clown, who had a bit of a change to his power, as well as add-ons. Legion that has had basically a full-on overhaul with their ability, as well as Legion. Oh, yeah, very smart of me. As well as Trickster, which is, in this next PTB, getting a massive update to his ability and changing a lot of stuff about him. You'd call each of these reworks. So the ongoing theory that I've heard is that what if Michael Myers is also receiving a rework? Well, it's not Myers' knife, not exactly, but okay, so what if it's not exactly? It's still close enough. I'm gonna be honest, I don't see why they would bother teasing Michael getting a rework over just telling people. It's not like they teased the Trickster getting a rework. It's, I don't think we ever got teasers for any killer getting reworked, I'm gonna be honest. Correct me if I'm wrong on that. So for me, this seems like wishful thinking on a lot of the community who would love to see Myers get updated and become a better killer because of it. However, I highly doubt that's what's coming in this update, which does suck. I'd love to see a Myers update. That would be great. Next, I guess I wanted to address the other elephant in the room suggestion here, and that is The Five Nights at Freddy's chapter being a potential. In the FNAF movie, you do see the one and only Urpley Man that we all know and love, William Afton, wielding a knife. That could be somewhat similar to this. I don't know if there's any, like, actual shots of the knife to really compare. So, is this a Five Nights at Freddy's teaser? Look, I want Five Nights at Freddy's and Dead by Daylight. Quite a lot, actually. It is probably up there as one of my dream chapters to eventually see. Alien was another one of my dream chapters, so I'm absolutely thrilled that that did come in. However, as much as I would love to just down some FNAF copium, going, guys, it's going to be a Five Nights at Freddy's chapter. Just trust me, bro. That knife, that's Springtrap's knife. He's going to come in with a knife, guys. I don't buy it. Now, the one reason why I don't buy it, I don't think that they'd do something like this for a teaser for Five Nights at Freddy's. Now, I could be wrong. I mean, you know, I'd love to maybe be proven wrong tomorrow. Actually, it's today. Literally later after I upload this. Probably within the next, like, fucking 4 or 5 hours, I'm going to be proven right, wrong, or whatever here. And that's just from recording. So when this goes out, I don't know. You guys got a couple hours before I start making more content on this. Don't worry. You get a couple of videos this week while I'm also solving my editorial problem, so I can actually get myself up and back into editing videos. As well as I'm actually considering that I might do a DPD. I don't know. I was thinking maybe I'd do a DPD stream on the new PTB, or at least some content going over it. But alas, I'm gonna just say right now, I have no real strong suspicion of this being a FNAF chapter. I think they'd do more interesting. I honestly think if they were to tease Five Nights at Freddy's, I think they'd do it in a more, I guess, an interesting way. I don't know. Just the Shadow of a Knife teaser isn't a big, like, ooh, interest to me. It's cool and all, don't get me wrong. You know, no teaser is bad. I feel like they would do it in a more, like, subtle way to the series as a whole, not specifically the fact that Springtrap uses a knife. I mean, it's just, I don't know. I guess I would also probably say the same thing about Chucky, so, you know what? Maybe I'm wrong. Honestly, it's very possible. I just think that Chucky is more likely an outcome, but I'd love to be proven wrong about FNAF. But we really don't have any big reasonings for thinking Five Nights at Freddy's is what's coming in. I mean, yeah, sure, they have their connections to, you know, the FNAF movie through Blumhouse. I believe it's Blumhouse. But, you know, they have connections to the possibility of Scott Cawthon and maybe being able to get FNAF license into here. But let's be honest, I don't honestly think we've ever seen Five Nights at Freddy's properly licensed into something that wasn't Five Nights at Freddy's. We've never seen any, like, inclusion of to my knowledge at least, in anything else. Scott doesn't really do collaborations, and while the Springtrap for DVD has been going on for years, and honestly, it would be a W to see, like, something that a lot of people have wanted for many years, I don't think that it's Five Nights at Freddy's at the end of the day. As much as I think that would be awesome. Also, hi, Nightmare. So, I guess Chucky is the main leading thing, but I also want to say it could be something else. Really and truly, we are, from what I know, so here's the reasoning why people have been going here, and this is also, I'm gonna say right now, one of the reasons why I feel strongly towards it not being Five Nights at Freddy's. We're mainly basing our idea of it being Chucky not just off of this, image. There is one other, basically piece of media that people have been using, and that is the voice actors that are pretty prominently used for Dead by Daylight content. They go to, like, a certain place or whatnot. Voice actors, specifically one voice actor and one voice actress, posted the other day saying that we were really gonna like what's coming next or what's coming soon or whatnot, or something along those lines. And it was two of them, you know, one male and one female. So if this was for DBD, we know we're not getting a survivor with this chapter. Which is the other reason why I do not personally believe that we are going to be getting a Five Nights at Freddy's chapter. Honestly, especially with the movie, depending on the licensing right that was drawn for a Five Nights at Freddy's chapter, I would not be surprised if we got Mike as a survivor. Or they could even go with Vanessa as a survivor if they wanted to as well, if we were drawing from the movie or whatnot. I feel like we'd most likely get a survivor. I could be wrong for that. However, with a Chucky chapter, you would also get Tiffany as a possibility of a legendary skin for Chucky. I think this has a lot of merit of possibility. Just overall as a potential, because if these two are voice acting for the next Dead by Daylight chapter, that means we are getting at least a likelihood of two voices. And I don't know what you'd really do for a Five Nights at Freddy's chapter unless they're bringing in skins of other animatronics and they decided to do someone like maybe Baby, for example. I just don't see it. However, there was always the potential that that post is unrelated. It's not like they only do DBD voice work. They do other things. But it is very possible that it is unrelated. However, I do have to say I have a feeling Chucky is the most likely. Now, I'm going to say this here. I really hope that, especially with the possibility of a Tiffany skin, this means we're going off of original Chucky. I'm not exactly a... I wouldn't say a huge Chucky fan. I've seen a couple of them. They're pretty fun and cheesy. However, I would be really disappointed if it was that recent movie remake where they've completely removed the whole, you know, Charles Lee Ray thing. That just really didn't, that wasn't Chucky in my opinion. That was a different idea that just eventually got the Chucky IP branded onto it. And honestly, is just so far removed from the rest of the series as a whole. So yeah, I guess, again, really overall, Chucky is probably the leading possibility, which I find very interesting since I believe Chucky was kind of called out in the past by Matthew Cote. So for a while, I know Chucky was talked about as like, you know, would be cool, whatnot. But I think there's a point in time when Matthew Cote kind of called out that Chucky wasn't going to work in DBD, if I remember correctly. And I am interested to see, I do have one big problem with the potential of a Chucky chapter that I want to go over, and that is the size. Oh my god, cat. Ah. Ah. Sorry, my cat was just yelling at me there. It's the size issue. Chucky is small. Very small. It would be like, I love the example that's been used, and I'm going to use it here. It'd be like playing Victor. If you guys don't know, Charlotte and Victor make up the killer known as the Twins. Charlotte is your normal-sized base movement speed killer, and Victor is this tiny little shit who's real small into the ground. It would be like having that as your POV the entire game, and that just doesn't seem very fun and interesting. I sure as hell wouldn't want to, and that would make looping miserable, because even on some normally not quite as safe loops, it's going to be near impossible to actually see where Chucky is. So unless they do a sizing up of Chucky and the license holders are okay with this, I have a big problem with Chucky coming into Dead by Daylight just to the size alone. A lot of people have brought up the Naughty Bear skin as like a proof of concept or idea. I just don't know if I'd say that that really proves much of anything. Yeah, sure, we have goofy skins or whatnot, but at the end of the day, really and truly, my issue with Chucky isn't an aesthetic thing. It's a size issue. They have to scale him up, or I think he's honestly going to be a really unfun killer to go against and to play as just from that size issue alone. Because, let me tell you, playing against someone who is the size of Victor is kind of annoying. Honestly, like, imagine, you gotta imagine, like, how hits are gonna look. Hits are gonna look so disgusting because of the size and, like, lunges. It's gonna look like this little fucker's going, like, Mach 70. Just to be able to hit you with, you know, normal M1 range, I think the size issue is really just my biggest issue, and how they're going to translate him. And he has to have a basic attack. Every killer has to, because otherwise he's literally just being denied some perks for no reason. So you got to keep that in mind. I don't know. Scaled up Chucky is the best I could ever see Chucky coming in. Otherwise, I do still think Chucky could be a problem, and not a killer I'd see being fun. So if it's not Chucky, are we really saying that Five Nights at Freddy's is the runner-up? Honestly, this could be a lot of people. You know, murderers just in general. But I don't know if they'd go down that route. I mean, murderers as in, like, obviously, you know, Hollywood ones. But I don't know. This seems like a really odd teaser, and I don't know how to make heads or tails of it. Chucky's most likely, but only if they've solved the size conundrum. Otherwise, I feel like Chucky is always never going to be a possibility. Unless they find a way to be able to rectify that. Maybe they just didn't and said, fuck it, we're just going to ball. You know, we want to get this license in. But yeah, I think saying that this is a Meyer rework is copium. That's the least likely possibility. As much as I love a Meyer's rework, I don't see it happening in the same time that we're getting a Trickster rework and they're teasing this one instead of just telling us. Like, I don't know. I don't buy it. We know we're getting a license, though, so we know this chapter later today is being revealed to us. I'll give you guys more info then. Until then, that's Nathan Nightmare out, and don't worry. I know I said I was coming back and then I kind of died again. I really am coming back this time. It's just been not a great last couple of weeks. For those of you who stick around for the end, just hear this quick. It's been a little rough. I actually lost like 2 family members just last week. I may not have been really close to them at all, but still, it's literally people in my family fucking dying. That's never a happy thing. And there's just been a couple other things. You know, like I said, I ran into that issue with my fucking editing software. Everything's been frustrating. But thank you guys so much, and see you guys the next time. Bye-bye.